Get ready to learn how you can retouch your phone pictures like a pro on Snapseed. With my efforts on this video, I hope you will learn the way I did my pictures, which makes them look at least 10 times more appealing to a casual viewer. So Snapseed was a photo editing app by Nix Software, which was acquired by Google back in 2012. It's one of my favorite apps and I truly love it more than any other app I've tried on the phone, especially Lightroom, because all it does is give you a variety of filters and nothing more than what Instagram can give you by default. So I am going to show you how to edit your pictures like a pro on the app. I use some of the settings throughout the app and these settings are more than enough for me to edit any picture I take from the phone and even from my cameras. So in the styles option, you will see a lot of presets you get on the app, and then the real magic lies on the tools options, where you get so many different tools and options to edit your picture that truly this app has made me stop using Photoshop so much just to edit my pictures, especially from the phone. The first option is tune image. You get a variety of different brightness, contrast, saturation settings, and if you go on to details, it's like sharpening up your picture, adding more structure to it. Likewise, there is curves, there's white balance, crop, rotate, perspective. Perspective is a really cool tool which Snapseed provides. You can literally fix the overall perspective of the picture both in vertical and horizontal axis, which is a very rare feature any of other apps will give you. If I try and talk about all the other features, all the other tools, this video is going to be very, very long. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to share my practical use with you of how I edit my pictures. I took this picture in North Delhi, India. So generally with a picture like this, I don't spend much time tweaking individual settings at first. What I do is that I go into HDR-scape, and there are four options here, and the app will try to guess which scenario is there on the picture. So right now it has chosen fine by default, which is not bad actually, but if I try the other options like nature, people, fine and strong, I think even the strong one looks good, but I'll choose the fine one. I'll immediately apply this effect on it, and then what I'll do is I'll go to tune image, and there I will add some shadow to the overall picture. It depends on you. You can also decrease the overall shadows if you believe that is going to make the picture look even more appealing to your viewers. And if I click on this little button here, it will automatically adjust and put whatever settings are the best for your current picture. And this is the histogram. Even if you go on to tune image again and choose this option, it will again do the same effects, because it's basically taking into consideration of all the brightness, color, white balance values which are currently on the picture. And according to that, the app is applying whatever effects and changes and settings it thinks is suitable for the current picture. But I don't like this in the end, because I've already put some effects on it. So I'll go back, I'll go into curves, I'll check if it is doing some justice to the picture. And then I'll go into details and add some structure to the overall picture. Now what else I can do is I can choose selective, choose the sun, decrease the overall effect of it, and then go into structure, and then just like that, the overall picture changes like this. Not bad at all. So doing these many changes through a single app, which is free on your phone, is a big deal, because before 2010, 2012, there weren't many such apps on the phone. And if you take a picture, unless and until you sit on your PC or laptop, you won't be able to edit your pictures as you would have wanted. There were a lot of apps which used to give you a lot of default presets, but that's about it. But this has been a big deal for many years now, and I simply love how convenient editing pictures has become in the past few years. I took this picture in Palampur, which is in Himachal Pradesh in India. Beautiful place. As you can see, a lot is going on with the picture. There's a statue in the middle, some mountains at the back. What I'll do is I'll go to HDR-scape first, and let's see by default how good it processes the picture in a more automated natural HDR tone. Let's see the nature first. People, fine and strong. If I click on nature, it kind of tries to maintain more shadows on the picture, so I think this is a good setting. I'll decrease it a little. Tune image. So let's try the highlight one first. If I decrease it, I can get more details on the clouds above. Yep, that's good. And if I try to add more shadow, the area around the statue and this area around the trees gets a little more brightened up, which is cool. I think I want that. And if I go to saturation and increase the saturation a bit, I can get more greens and more blues on the mountain and on the grass. Like, immediately the picture looks so much better than the original one. I think I overdid the saturation part, but that's fine. If I want to get a little greedy and add more details to the picture, let's see how it turns out. I would feel that keeping the structure 200 is going to make the picture even better, because now I can see more details on it. But trust me, never do that to your pictures. So decrease it. I should maintain it around 15, 16 or 17. Save it. I think I've done quite enough justice to the picture. And this beautiful picture I took from the comfort of my home and desktop. Hey hey. Subscribe if you like the video so far. I took this picture from the chirping bird, which is in Mukteshwar. This sunrise was something which I might never forget. So let's go on to selective first. I'm going to zoom inside the area of the sun and go to tools. Click on selective and just select this area. And first I'm gonna add some structure to it. I think that's about it. I'm gonna go to HDR-scape. This looks too much. And I'm gonna select fine and decrease the filter strength to, let's say, I think around this value, it's good. But I feel the picture has been darkened a lot. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm going to go into curves and increase the overall brightness of the image. If you guys also do like this, the same pattern, a dot in the middle and a dot on the top, and by increasing the topmost dot a little, you will be controlling the contrast on the picture. I need a little more brightness and a little more contrast. I can do more with it. I can add more details to the overall picture. And again, I can add more brightness to the picture, overall brightness. The best thing is, whatever steps, whatever iterations you put on your image, you can always go back by clicking here and undoing your last command. So you can totally transform your pictures with this single app. Since I have started using it, I have stopped using Photoshop on my computer to edit my pictures. I think they do great justice with retouching any picture you would want to retouch. This last picture was taken by some visitor during my visit at Auto Expo in 2018 in Noida, India. So if I try to edit this picture, my face has quite a less light on it. So what I'll do is I'll go to selective, zoom in on my face a little and increase the brightness around this area. I can also increase or decrease the size of this effect by simply dragging my two fingers on the screen and zooming in and zooming out. Go into brightness, increase the brightness a little. There's a little difference here. And then go to tune image, go to shadows, increase the shadows just a bit so that the overall image doesn't look extremely flat. Click on it and go again into tune image and go into highlights. Decrease the highlight so that the background, which is extremely bright, has lesser light than it has currently right now. So I'll decrease the highlights again because the previous effect didn't have much change on the picture. And now I'll again go to tune image, go to shadows, add a little more shadows. And then go into curves, increase the curve a little bit, and by putting a dot here on the lower curve, I can control the contrast and saturation a bit more. There's a lot of brightness around this area on the top. So what I'm gonna do is again go into selective, tap here, increase the overall effect of it, and then go to brightness and decrease it. The overall picture is quite tilted, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna fix the rotation of it. So I'm going to click on rotation. So this is a new update that the rotate is kind of fixing the overall rotation of the image by itself, and I think it did a pretty good job. So I'm gonna click on okay. So this is how the picture looks now after retouching it. And this is why I don't go on my computer now to retouch any of my pictures, especially the ones which I take from my phone. If I have captured from my DSLR or the other camera and I'm just lazy to copy them on the phone, then only I use Lightroom on my Windows desktop to edit those pictures. But whichever picture I take on the phone, I simply edit it on Snapseed and be happy with it.
Hope I was able to explain my process of retouching well enough with this video. I'm a bad teacher, but I try my best to explain. Do subscribe if I was able to help you with this video. That's all for today. MewBot out.